Hey YouTube, it's Mark
and Rocky,
and we are here today to talk to you about an exciting ship, one of our personal favorites. In fact, I think it's my most sailed ship.
It is mine as well.
I've got 59 nights and you've got
30.
So between the two of us, we're platinum on Carnival
Splendor.
The Carnival Splendor, the pink and zebra
polka dot.
Okay, so the Carnival Splendor, she holds a very special spot, obviously, in our hearts. We've sailed her many, many times. And when we found out that she was going to be repositioning to Australia,
we were worried.
We knew that they were going, Carnival was bringing her in to do a significant dry dock to get her ready for the Australian market.
Right, and they had just done the similar dry dock for the Sunshine class. So we knew what happened to those ships.
They completely were overhauled. And so what was gonna happen to the Splendor? Was she going to be the same? If you watched our previous video, you saw some of the before and after clips.
Yep.
Right here. Today we want to talk to you about some additional things that we've discovered are different on Splendor 2.0.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that. Splendor 2.0.
Splendor 2.0.
What we can tell you is the Splendor
is still the Splendor. Still has Farcus reigning strong across
Joe
the
Farcus,
ship.
Joe Farcus, Carnival's classic designer. So let's start with the staterooms, because that's a difference.
So the staterooms used to be a little bit more pink.
They had the Carnival Cruise Line pink. If you've sailed on a Carnival cruise, you know that pink, that border that goes around, the pink bedspread, the pink curtains if you're in the balcony room, the drapes. They've really updated that to go to the more nautical.
Yeah, there's more blues and greens, and it's a little bit less in your face with the design color choices, I would say.
Yeah, so it's definitely the new Carnival Cruise Line theme. Yeah. Blue carpeting, even the carpeting is different in the room.
Is,
and so we'll put some before and after pictures right here somehow. And so you can see that it has some elements of Farcus still left.
It does.
But
not very much.
Not very much.
Not
so
very much.
The rooms are indeed different. I would say they're an upgrade.
They are, yeah, they look great.
Food, there's a bunch of food changes as well that go into this ship. So if you've watched any of our videos before, you know we talk about food, we talk about drinks, we talk about entertainment. So
in that order.
So food offerings, there are a couple of new additions to the Splendor post-dry dock.
There are. So they've made some changes to the pizza place. So she doesn't have the pizza pirate any longer. Mm-hmm. And that has been sad to see it go. They took out all of those greens and teals that were in that area because the pizza pirate sat in the Lido pool area, the midship area.
The mid Lido.
Yeah.
And so pizza pirate normally is a dark kind of red and black color, but because it was in the Lido, mid Lido, it was themed to match. It was actually kind of a cool pizza pirate because it was unique.
Yeah.
So they replaced that with Pizzeria del Capitano.
Yep.
They're more upscale kind of pizza brand. But the upgraded colors, the whites and reds, fit.
They fit the new design of the space. The new space has more whites throughout.
Yep.
And it also has some more wood tones, but they're not aggressive like they are on the Freedom if you've sailed on that ship.
Totally true. Also new, they've replaced the grill. The chili dogs and the hamburgers and some of those, you know, pasta salads, they've replaced that with...
Yeah, Guy's Burger Joint is now on the Carnival Splendor.
What's interesting is the Splendor was the last ship in the fleet that did not have Guy's Burger. So now you can get your Ringer or your Plain Jane or the new Thunderstruck Nacho Burger for a limited time. Check it out here.
So with Guy's Burger,
mm-hmm.
as with most of the Carnival ships, you would expect there to be your other favorite. They used to have the burrito bar in the Lido Buffet.
Oh, that's right.
And we were expecting that maybe they would upgrade the burrito bar into
Blue Iguana. You know, someone claimed that there wasn't enough room. The reality is with where the pizza is, they would have had to have ripped out the pizza altogether to put in a Blue Iguana and retrofit that space.
Right.
They would have had to have moved the pizza where the deli is and found a spot for the deli. And there really isn't a spot.
There isn't, no.
And so what they did was they took the burrito. They did still eliminate the burrito bar.
Yes, they did.
So not only did they not add Blue Iguana,
you cannot get burritos on the Carnival Splendor anymore.
Cannot. If you are craving a burrito on the Carnival Splendor, might not be the right ship for you.
Yeah.
they removed the burrito bar from, it was in aft Lido in the buffet area.
Yes.
And they put in
Seafood Shack.
So the upcharge.
The upcharge seafood dining experience.
Yeah. Yep. It was the last ship in the fleet that didn't have a Guy's Burger and Blue Iguana.
Yep.
Still no.
Still no Blue Iguana.
I'm kind of glad, honestly, that they didn't put Blue Iguana in, because one of the things that they could have done is they could have taken over another space, which is my personal favorite, which is Masala Tiger, the
right.
Indian restaurant. That's exclusively, it is only available on Carnival Splendor.
So they're actually, it's kind of interesting because there was an Indian themed restaurant or dining option in that same space before Masala Tiger, and that was Tandoor.
Yep, and Tandoor was on several Carnival ships. In fact, the Dream Class, it was on all of the Dream Class, and one by one, as those ships went into dry dock and retrofit, they yanked that free option, Tandoor, in preference to put in the
Seafood Shack.
So aft starboard side, they yanked Tandoor, and I was really nervous. I'm not going to lie. I had tears in my eyes as I took my first bite of Masala Tiger. Well, it's been rebranded. And Serenity, as you saw in the first video, Serenity moved to the aft of the ship.
Right.
So they rebranded Masala Tiger to better fit in with the teals.
It's
and the,
beautiful.
Oh, it's beautiful. Well, you're probably going to put a picture here and here. Actually, we'll throw in some pictures of Masala Tiger because it is beautiful when you compare it to the old, because they retrofitted. Remember those, the tubes or the pipes that were the ceiling?
Yeah.
All just now white.
Just paneled,
white paneling. And the food, I mean, honestly, it's a new brand.
It's still the same food.
It's the same food, and it was truly delicious. So, in summary, kind of glad that they didn't find a spot for Blue Iguana, because it likely would have bumped Masala Tiger out.
Right.
And like Rocky said, Tandoor, it was the last Tandoor of its kind on Carnival Cruise Lines. One of the dining options that's been added is Fahrenheit 555.
Oh, yeah.
And so Fahrenheit 555, they just took the old steakhouse.
Pinnacle,
the Pinnacle Steakhouse, and they just slapped a tag that says Fahrenheit 555. Not one of Carnival's probably better rebrands based on this picture that you see here, but I don't know how many people book the steakhouse because of the signage.
No.
Okay, and what about sushi?
So that's one thing that does not exist on the Splendor any longer.
They had it on the Splendor.
They did for a brief period of time where the Taste Bar was located.
We're going to have to do a video some point on the Taste Bar. For any of you Carnival fans out there, you remember the Taste Bar, those amuse bouches that you would get before you went over to Alchemy to have a drink, or El Mojito.
Yeah, anyway, El Mojito on the Splendor.
Oh. So it's gone.
It is gone. And in its place, they put the Java Blue Cafe.
It was the Taste Bar, which is a free offering, and Carnival was like, no,
Right.
They put in Sushi at Sea,
right.
Which was their off-brand sushi, or off-brand,
yeah,
or
bonsai.
It's not a bonsai, it's the Sushi at Sea. That must not have performed, and so they ripped that entire section out, and they put in a giant Java Blue. So that tells me
Java Blue probably makes a little bit more money for the cruise line. More people are gonna spend their money on a little coffee than they are gonna on a roll.
And if you think about it, that operates from morning until late at night. And whereas sushi or the
Sushi Express.
Would not draw that kind of crowd.
Right. Right.
And even though the Splendor had a coffee spot,
right,
it was teeny tiny.
It was a little thing.
It was a small thing. They kept the spot, but
But now it's a juice bar.
So
not as busy, which is ideal for that setup.
True. So Carnival truly probably saw two ways to make money out of those spaces. Keep the coffee shop, but convert it into juice and treats, and add in a Java Blue. So that entire area, it's utilized. So that's deck five. So the main walkway on the older ships, deck five. If you go further aft, switching gears to the bars.
So
we talked about Java Blue.
Of course, we're already in the bars.
We're already in the bars and drinking. Alchemy, line favorite Alchemy.
Yeah, that replaced El Mojito.
Yes.
So El Mojito Bar was a very interesting design, almost Marrakesh style, if you're familiar with that design style.
I am not Marrakesh. I'm not familiar. Nope.
But it was very almost Middle Eastern, even though it was called El Mojito. And so it was definitely a different experience. It was dark. I wouldn't say that it was out of place. It was very traditional Carnival from those days.
Yeah. It didn't have the vibe that Alchemy has. It didn't have that funship vibe. It was, like you said, it was quiet. Mm-hmm. Even though in recent years they had switched it to be kind of more of a martini bar and more upscale,
right.
It didn't. There are people that follow us or that we talk to that literally book on Carnival because of Alchemy.
It's true.
And so Splendor.
They have their drinks that they know and love, and Alchemy is their go-to place.
Yep. Yep.
So where the El Mojito, when that was still in existence, do you remember those chairs and that lounger that was sitting over there?
They were the ugliest. I mean, most beautiful Joe Farcus touches,
yes,
uncomfortable. No one used them.
And they were kind of in the way.
Well, especially with how they built the Alchemy Bar, the lower seating for
accessible
seating. Right. Like, you wouldn't have been able to get through the pathway with those chairs there anymore.
Right.
So those are gone.
So there's a pretty big bar that changed was needed.
It needed.
Down on deck fore aft, there was kind of this dead space. It was a very dark bar, very similar to El Mojito.
A cigar bar, originally.
It was a cigar bar, mm-hmm. Very, very true. And that was called
the Robusto Lounge.
Yeah.
I mean, that place never had a soul in it. Maybe karaoke night, they tried to draw people down
there.
There
were like two or three people for karaoke night.
The bar was never open. No, it was open during karaoke.
Of course.
But that was the only time the bar was ever open. I always used to joke, like, if you need a quiet place on the ship to get away, to escape to, go to Robusto, because no one's going to be there.
Yeah, not the library. Go to the Robusto.
Yeah, yes, yes.
And so that space has been completely redone. It is gorgeous. I'm impressed at how they fit in the Red Frog pub.
It is amazing what a fresh coat of paint can do.
Oh, there's more than just a fresh coat of paint.
It feels like that space is double the size.
Oh, it's huge.
It's the same.
Right.
I mean, it's the same size, but it feels like it's double the size.
I think that's partly because it was busy every time we walked through it.
It was busy. There was something going on. There was live music. There were the Red Frog Pub drinks,
those specialty drinks.
The games. The windows were open during the day, so it let in the natural light. Unlike Robusto, which was always dark.
A cigar bar, I mean.
Yes, yeah. So that was a big change. So we've talked about the room, we've talked about the food, we've talked about the drinks. What about
the
fun?
Stuff.
What about the fun?
Now we gotta talk about the fun. Yeah, so let's
It's a fun ship, after all.
It is a fun ship. Let's talk about one of the most visually striking changes that happened to the Splendor.
I mean, it's a big one, too.
Yeah. So the Splendor used to have the blue and teal twister water slide.
The classic single slide on all the Carnival ships until only the last 10 years.
Right.
So they replaced it with Waterworks, doubled the capacity by putting in two slides, not just one,
but two
slides. The yellow one.
Right, which was the twister.
The green one.
Which is Green Lightning.
What's interesting about Green Lightning is she has a sister called the Green Thunder. The Green Thunder, they both have drops.
Yes, they have a drop floor.
But the Green Lightning, which is on Splendor, has the toilet bowl versus the Green Thunder.
Right, which just has a slide run out.
The exit spout, yep.
So
you've got Waterworks, you've got the kids' play area.
You remember the old Next Cruise desk?
Oh, where you could go and you could book a cruise and you could save $50 or something like that.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they ripped that out. It was a tiny little space across from where the current juice bar is. And that's now cherry on top.
Again, another pay venue where you can get your little rubber duckies and candy.
But check out these gates that they put up on this new facility.
It is the coolest cherry on top. It is the most unique and coolest cherry on top in the fleet. So we've talked a lot about the changes, a couple of structural changes, a big one, aft.
Yeah, so when they moved the Serenity to the back end of the ship on deck 9, they also changed that bar that's over on the port side so that it has service from both the Serenity side as well as the deli side.
Mm-hmm.
And in doing that, they removed a staircase.
They just, literally, we were walking aft of the ship one day on port side and we're like, okay, let's go down. Where? This is weird. We had to go all the way to starboard to go down. And we're like, that's really weird. And it bugged us because we're like, it doesn't match what we remember and it doesn't match the typical Carnival design. So we pulled up the deck plans of the old Splendor.
Well, not only that, but we also saw the changes in the welding.
you can actually see, if you look closely and follow kind of where it was, you can see the old, where the old stairwell used to be.
Yep.
And then the other big structural change we noticed, and literally I noticed this the very first day as we were walking out, and there was this big metal new box, and it's a handicap accessible restroom, which is something Carnival has been doing now for the past several years, is adding in more handicap accessible, adding in more egress or pathways as well.
Right.
Which is great.
It is. So if you've made it this far, there's just a couple little things that we want to share that we noticed on our walks around the ship.
Some general changes.
Yeah. So as we went into the Cloud Nine Spa, which we have so lovingly booked rooms in before.
I know where you're going.
The Thalasso pool was a big deal when the Splendor came out. She was the first in Carnival's fleet to feature the Thalasso therapy pools. And one of the fanciest things about that pool was those dragons that were looming over the water. Strange. It did not really have anything to do with Cloud Nine Spa or anything like that.
I don't think Cloud Nine Spa was a thing.
Oh, no, clearly.
When Splendor actually launched in 2009.
2009, yeah.
I don't think Cloud Nine was a brand that was implemented on her. She had these beautiful dragons.
Yes. Multicolored,
gorgeous. Definitely a Farcus touch. Yes. Definitely a Joe Farcus touch. But when they rebranded her to Cloud Nine, they left them in initially.
Yep.
But then when she went into dry dock, they yanked them out.
They did pull them.
I will say, I hate to say it because I love those dragons, but it is amazing how much it opened up that space.
Yeah.
Much brighter. They redid the lighting in there. Just a very relaxing space.
It is. It's much more relaxing. You don't have dragons looking down on you.
But they were a cool touch.
They were.
Carpeting. We talked about carpeting in the stateroom.
Yeah. Carpeting across the whole ship has honestly changed.
Carpeting, and you featured that a little bit in the first video, but yes. Stairs.
Yeah, the stairs. So we definitely noticed on a couple of stairwells where they didn't fully cut out the original carpet when they laid the new one in. I think there may have been a glue problem. And so as we were going down the stairs one day, we noticed that there was a bright pink and blue piece of carpeting shining through at us.
I don't know if this is going to show up in this video for you or not, but we were tickled.
So in addition to the carpeting that we saw across the ship, the dining rooms even, that one was a little disappointing to me.
That was disappointing because the carpet was in great shape dining rooms.
Yeah.
And it matched the theme of the dining room.
It matched the theme. You had the gold pearl and the black pearl, and the carpeting was pearls. I mean, it was an exact replica or duplication of what you saw overhead was on the ground.
It was such a great theming element of the restaurant. It was beautiful. The carpet was in great shape. The new carpeting, I will say, does look very nice.
It does.
Does look very nice. But I didn't.
But it's not the gold pearl.
I didn't see the need to pull it out. And then the last thing to mention would be. This is a small one, but the theater.
Yeah, the theater. This is a common change that we've seen across the other ships. So they took out the projection screens that are on both sides of the theater stage, mm-hmm. and they replaced it with flat screen TVs. Yeah. So we are so glad that we had the opportunity to sail on the Carnival Splendor in Alaska a couple months ago. Mm-hmm. It was such an honor to be able to get back onto that ship, but For everyone that's down in Australia, enjoy her. She's a beautiful ship.
Take care of her for us. Please, take care of her.
She has all of the Carnival needs and fun ship things that need to make your enjoyment,
minus blue iguana.
Minus blue iguana. That need to make your vacation amazing. Yeah. We want to hear what your thoughts are. What do you miss from the Carnival Splendor?
Did we miss something for anyone who sailed her pre-dock, dry dock? To now, did we miss stuff? What did we miss that you caught that we didn't see?
Absolutely. Let us know.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll have to do a part three.
I don't think there's enough footage for a part three.
There's not.
But as always, we thank you. Thanks for tuning in as we talk about our favorite ship and some obscure things about our favorite ship.
Yeah.
And of course,
please remember to like and subscribe.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye.